Robert Sheldon.
My name is Colin Miller, and as the district's fine arts coordinator and one of the assistant principals here at Fond du Lac High School, I'm deeply grateful and honored to be serving as your MC and tour guide of sorts for this afternoon's event. Today's Band-O-Rama concert features all 10 of the Fond du Lac School District bands individually, as well as the formation of the final mass band, featuring the over 700 students in the band program. Our guest composer and conductor is Mr. Robert Sheldon. All of our bands will perform pieces composed by Mr. Sheldon. The piece currently being performed by the Fond du Lac High School Symphonic Winds and Percussion is his Overture to a New Horizon.
Thank you.
Our elementary band program is made up of two bands. The Tuesday band and the Wednesday band, both under the direction of Mary Liz Jocka and Kathy Hansen. These students get together once per week on their respective days as a full band, which started in November and rehearses at Riverside Elementary School. They will begin their musical journey with us today. He's called Uptown Strut. Now, I do need to include and honor a few names that were inadvertently left off of the program, thanks to the wonders of technology. We're going to honor those students by announcing their names. All the other students' names are listed in the program, but Ben Lally, Cohen Liven, Jason Van Melroy, Jessica Mendez, Lily Miller, Anna Nimmer, Jasmine Ponce, and Alexia Ramirez. There was a chunk of names, unfortunately, that were not included, so we announced their names. Uptown Strut portrays a lighthearted stroll through the big city. An air of calm and confidence sets the mood as we dress to impress in the streets. Brief musical conversations are interjected as we meet others on our walk, our musical walk uptown. Listen for this. Listen for the hello, the brass, the hi there, the woodwinds, the what's new by the curmudgeon low bass, and the not much by the low brass. Please enjoy our beginning fifth grade band playing Uptown Strut, and please welcome our guest composer and conductor for today, Mr. Robert Sheldon. Chicago's Orchestra Hall, Boston Symphony Hall, Taipei's National Concert Hall, Masumoto's Seiji Ozawa Performing Arts Center, the Sydney Opera House, and the Kennedy Center for the Performing Arts in Washington, D.C., and today, the Fun Life High School Field House. It's been a tradition to combine the three middle school sixth graders into one band for this Band-O-Rama concert. This year, they are also joined by the sixth, seventh, and eighth grade students from STEM. Presto, by Robert Chopin, is a selected composition for this group. Sixth grade bands are under the direction of all three middle school band directors, Ashley Hypus, Mike Fedison, and Nicole Gillespie, along with the STEM band director, Kathy Hansen. A bit about this composition, Presto. It's a joyful, fast-paced composition, which is both challenging but exciting for the students performing it. Here are the combined sixth grade students from Savish, Tyson, Woodworth, and their musical friends from STEM Institute. Setting this common standard for conduct across the Air Force. These values inspire the trust which provides the unbreakable bond that unifies the Air Force. And now Savish Middle School with Integrity. the middle school band. For many years, Nicole Koleski has been working with the elementary students at the Fond du Lac School District. She's conducted those elementary bands for several years, but today she is proud of teaching at her alma mater, Tyson Middle School. The Tyson students will be performing the piece Storm Warning. The shores of the Great Lakes are noted for their intense storms. This piece attempts to paint a musical portrait of a beautiful lake shore before and during one of these events. Coming up, ladies and gentlemen, the 7th and 8th graders of Tyson Middle School and Storm Warning. She's proud to have her students perform Tales of Dundee under the baton of Robert Shelley.
Thank you.
Next is the concert band. They're the first of the three high school bands performing today. This group is made up of students grades 9 and 12, and it's the entry point of band instruction here at Fond du Lac High School. The concert band is directed by both Mr. Chris Barnes and Mr. Matt Bay. Today they will be performing a piece called Shanties.
Thank you.
The symphony band has selected Robert Sheldon's Metroplex. Metroplex is a musical portrait of Manhattan skyscraper. The piece opens with a vision of the New York skyline, evoking blue buildings and concrete canyons. From there, the melody travels to the heart of an urban jazz scene, characteristic of the city's famous nightclubs. And finally, the piece takes us on a wild taxi ride through the heavy traffic of a bustling metropolis. The skyline is seen once more as we leave Manhattan, hopefully to return in soon. Robert Sheldon and the Pontlock High School Symphony Band.
Thank you.
Today's musical journey has taken us from Scotland to Manhattan, and has included songs of the sea, epic Midwestern storms, and has paid tribute to the United States Air Force. Where else to go from here? Well, I suppose in late March, as it is today, we're wishing for warmer weather, and while we can't promise you that, we can certainly give you a little taste of the music to help you imagine that, feel like you've been transported to a warmer climate. Some bandoneons and percussion will perform Danzas Cubanas, three Cuban dances. This work features solos by Jake O'Donnell on piano, Grant Pettick on trombone, Kaya Pettick on flute, and Keegan Sponholz on trumpet. Sit back and enjoy, or dance along if you get the urge, and get down and in a little bit. Robert Sheldon, the symphonic winds and percussion, and Danzas Cubanas. right? And they did see some movement going on. So now you've heard our entire band program and the field house from grades 5 through 12 and the progression and the growth made throughout those years. I think it's time for you to soon, not just yet, stand, stretch, and we're going to let the bleachers soften up a little bit for you as we move into a minor miracle mode here. We're going to put these bands into one big band. And at that time, we're going to let you stand and stretch. But don't leave, because this setup, our goal is to have that done in 10 minutes. We're going to say it's 10 minutes no matter what. So, you can then stand and stretch for a bit, and we'll be back with you momentarily. And direction and very cooperative from the people. While I have just a moment before we move on, I wanted to also encourage you, if you have a chance, and maybe you've already done so, to take a minute when you can and read the welcome in the program that Mr. McVeigh wrote. It has a very meaningful and insightful message, and I hope that you'll have a chance to read it. And also this time I wanted to acknowledge, and I'm going to ask them to stand. I want to acknowledge two of our wonderful groups that help us in every possible way you can imagine, help us be the band and the music department that we are. And for Music Parents, which is an umbrella organization in the district, an umbrella fine arts organization, we have the officers of Ms. Robin Spidell. You get a stand, she is the president. And we're holding you up because we want to give you an option. If Anne Menge is here, she is our treasurer. Miss Tina DeMox, where are you? Is Tina here? Well, she is. Thank you ever so much for what you do, and if these ladies call on you, please help them out. They are the Music Parents Organization. And also, we want to acknowledge Fondy Band Boosters. We have Faith Gerner and Leah Pettit, our co-presidents. You're here. Stand here. Christine Sesson, our co-vice presidents. Tina Duffy, secretary. And Mitch and Kim Williams, treasurer. So thank you from the bottom of our hearts. They're there for everybody. Financial presence, they're organizing, they are coordinating everything for the band. So I think we're about ready to go. So how does that, are we settling this group? Good to go. You've already heard what our district students can do as individual groups, but the power of this event is what's formed right behind me. This is the 2017 Band-O-Rama Mega Band. We have two final selections for you. We will begin by honoring our country, which makes all of this possible. America the Beautiful was written by Samuel Moore, and this arrangement, which is playable by all grade levels, was written by Robert W. Smith. He was a conductor-composer for our 2008 Band-O-Rama concert. And here we are with America the Beautiful.
Thank you. sits behind me and in front of you. This doesn't happen without just a tremendous team of people to make it happen. And I do want to take some time today to recognize some of the people behind the scenes who help all of those band directors make this possible. And I do want to recognize Terry Davis, who sets up all the ticketing. This is the first year that we have done online tickets. And I think taking that step has been really smooth for us and made ushering 1,600 people into this field house really, really helpful. So thank you, Terry Davis. I want to thank Brian Appleby for not calling the fire marshal. Brian has actually put in a ton of work to make sure that this facility can host an event like this. And in fact, Brian works with a team of maintenance crew from across the district that had to move all of the equipment that you see behind me throughout the course of the days on Thursday and Friday. And they did just one heck of a job to make this possible. So thank you to them. For several weeks, Jenna Sheridan spent some time working in the band room during eighth period on basically a student work release, putting together a lot of the stuff for this event, organizing it, and also putting together the program. So I want to thank Jenna for the work that she did. Holly Miller has been our fine arts coordinator for years and works tirelessly behind the scenes to make sure not just music, but also visual art get the support that they need in our school district. And I want to publicly thank her for her work there and thank her for being the voice of Band-O-Rama this year. For all of us current band directors, we didn't invent this event, we inherited this event. And it has been going on, like I put in the program, it's a 53-year tradition that we're very proud to continue to carry that torch. And it was kept going for years and years and years by just an unbelievable world-class instrumental educator group that we had here at Final Act High School. And I want to recognize any band director, any music teacher, past or present, that is in our audience today. Would you please stand and be recognized? Parents, go ahead and please take the time to let them know how much their work to support your child's music education means to you. Because they're the people that need to stand up for your child when scheduling a lesson perhaps maybe isn't the most convenient thing to do, but it's the right thing to do. They're the ones who have to work very, very hard to make sure that our teachers have the resources that they need to make sure children get a great experience in all subjects. And I want to publicly thank school administrators. If you're here, please stand and be recognized as well. Parents, I believe that arts instruction for students is one of the absolute best things that they can achieve. And I put some comments in there on the welcome that I hope you can read and take with you a little bit. But it goes beyond that. You know, the work that students do and the stuff that they did today, it may not show up on a standardized test. I would actually argue that it does. But that's not why they do what they do. But for every single kid, what they did today influenced their lives, influenced your life, influenced their community. And when a kid goes in them and they have music instruction, whether it be in kindergarten or senior in high school, their day gets better. Their school environment is improved, and in fact, the entire world, I think, heals just a little bit when that process happens. And we need people to be strong advocates for that, because like I said, it's not always something that we put a number next to, but sometimes numbers aren't the most important thing, our kids are the most important thing. And making sure that they have the absolute best experience in their life is really what being a parent, being a teacher is all about. And so as much as you can continue to be our champions for that voice in our community, that goes a long way to making sure that this experience happens for the next generation of musicians in time to come. So thank you, parents, for being here. I want to recognize you as well. And lastly, you have seen him wave the baton all afternoon, but I would like to recognize and turn the microphone over to our guest composer, our guest conductor, Mr. Robert Shelton.
hopeful that the next few days we'll get a chance to meet all of these terrific, talented people behind me, and the dedicated parents and faculty that work for them to teach them to do all these wonderful things. I'm so glad to see so many of you today, because it's wonderful to see the total community support for this. And personally, it's really fun to stay in front of the entire city. It's great. No, thank you. As a conductor, as a teacher, as a composer, one of the most enjoyable parts of all this for me is getting a chance to share music, not always mine, but just to share music with your friends. And it was really fun today, with this week, I guess, to be able to share with 800 friends. And I really enjoyed coming up, and I want to thank the directors from Fond Lab for inviting me to be a part of this really incredible event. You are so fortunate. Other places don't do this. There's probably a lot of good reasons, but it's really hard work. And your teachers put in, and your kids put in an immense amount of work to make it happen. So I want to thank the teachers, thank the students, and I certainly want to thank you for being here today, too. Really enjoyed sharing my music with the kids, and it's also fun sharing music with a couple of very good friends of mine. The arrangement there very beautiful by Robert Smith, who's been a friend for years, and one of my good best friends, my ballet just put in one of his pieces to close out the program. So thank you for inviting me, thanks for being here, and all these wonderful kids in the back here. Filling this entire room, I just want to say thank you for being here. Welcome to the Royal Party. Thanks.
Thank you, Jason.
Thank you. Thank you.
Our final selection this afternoon, this is by Brian Ballmage's Winged Victory. Mr. Ballmage, again, we had said, was a Band-O-Rama featured guest in 2011. The piece was written for Kenosha School District, but we are incredibly proud to present it here today. You'll hear the wonder, the power of this composition that is incredibly grand in its presentation. Here with us once again, Mr. Robert Sheldon, Maestro. Would you please, Winged Victory.